Okay, great. I liked kind of watching the behind the scenes, the hair check and the knee
Oh yeah, we
check and
got hair
everything.
check and girl talk. It's a good thing we probably didn't say
Yeah, good thing I
something.
can't read lips. But it's great to meet you all. Hi, Solit. Hi, Doctor.
Nice to
And
see you.
first of all, I mean, this is a great because I feel like I'm watching Saturday morning on NBC, sing Punky years later. This is like a dream come true. So I just wanted to say this is
Oh,
awesome.
thank you. That means so much. I'm still very punky at heart. So I've got that like punky power constantly.
And that was my first question. After all these years, what gives you that punky power still?
Oh, you know, Punky is like my superhero. She's like the superhero within me. And when times are great, when I have hard times, like I just lean into her and she just gives me like so much light and love. And I'm so grateful. And I've always, you know, she's always been such a part of my heart and an extension of me. And so I always hold that very dear to me.
Well, she's an endearing character, and so are you who played her. And now you have four little punkies of your own.
I do. I have like an entire baseball team or football league or something. I have a 17-year-old, 15-year-old, 9-year-old, and 7-year-old. It's like I have a lot of children. Single mom, four kids. It is quite the juggling act.
And they all have unique names like their mom, so it runs in the family.
They do. I recently saw an SNL where they might have like pulled some of my children's names into it. Yeah, we have a poet, a lyric, a story, and Jagger. So yeah, some wild names. But it's like I have a name, you know, my name's Soleil. Of course my kids' names would be unique.
Yeah, I'm sure back in the 80s and 90s, there were lots of kids named after you. So there's a lot of other Soleils out there, I'm sure.
Oh.
But you're the one and only. But okay, so first of all, talk about your relationship with the doctor, how you guys teamed up and what you guys are
Oh,
working
with the doctor, with the doctor.
on now.
So, literally, we have been friends since 14 years old. We met at a UB40 concert.
Oh my
We've been
gosh,
there
red,
for
red
years
wine.
repeat. So, this is totally real. Like, we really are best friends forever, which makes this
BFFs.
so special, you know, to be able to work together on this. And it's such a passion, labor of love for both of us has been truly amazing. And, you know, I've learned so much through her. And now to be able to share it with friends and the world, it's just been incredible. And to be a part of this incredible Ask to Be Sure campaign with GSK and Lifetime has been really amazing. And with another one of my best friends, Melissa Joan Hart,
Oh,
who is
yeah.
part of the documentary with us, which has been incredible. And Lifetime, it's just been amazing. Dream
And
come true.
to the people at home, what's the short film about? You had questions, the doctor answered them, and what were the questions
Yes.
that you asked?
I think it's so important as families to be able to have conversations and ask our healthcare providers questions and ask to be sure. And, you know, when I learned about meningitis B, I, like so many other people, thought it was a vaccination that happened when the kids were younger. And I didn't realize that meningitis B was totally different. And I learned so much through my dear friend Shaka. And sorry, doctor. Okay, sorry. I call her Shaka. You know, and really, I felt like if I didn't know this, there must be so many millions of other families that didn't either. And I think it's important for us to have these conversations. And every family is different, and every family, you know, makes the choices that are right for their family. But I think it's really important that we have these conversations and that we aren't afraid to ask our doctors and our healthcare providers really important questions.
Yeah, and it's way better than Googling, oh, what is this? And how did they do this? Because you're going to get
Well,
answers that
and
aren't true.
literally, of course, the worst thing to do, which I am totally a fault of, is, I mean, when you go and Google anything, right? And anything medical, I'm like, oh, right, that is not the doctor. Ask your doctor.
Exactly, because
Or if you
any.
have a best friend in the family. But I also knew not everyone has their childhood best friend who grows up to be a doctor. So it's been so amazing in the sense that, like, I really do get to share this with someone that I love. And And I think that is so wonderful because it is so authentic, you know,
Yeah,
which
you're very lucky.
share with the world.
And I'm lucky because I get to do this with you and to share with all of the other families that everyone that's watching, so we can share that with everybody else.
Exactly. And you learn from each other. Maybe she brings up a question and you're like, oh, I didn't think about that. And then you go and research and do what you got to do. And I love the mutual just sort of collaboration there. So that's great.
Yeah,
and so doctor
absolutely.
Go ahead, Sole, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, you know, like over the years I'll just like put text exchanges with just hundreds and hundreds of parents on it. Do you know what I mean? I'm like, Shaka can tell us all. No, not really hundreds, but like my hand.
But it's good.
You are someone that I really trust so much. So
well, we're lucky. We're both lucky.
And Dr. Shaka, just tell a little bit about the meningitis B and what people need to know, especially now going into school, and just what do parents need to know?
So meningitis is an uncommon, but it's a serious infection, and it can cause severe complications and even death. And so teenagers and young adults ages 16 to 23 are an increased risk due to normal behaviors of that age group. They basically share everything. They live in really small shared quarters. And so that puts them at an increased risk. And these risks for meningitis B, is 1 in 10 can die in as quickly as 24 hours. And 1 in 5 can have permanent damage, such as brain damage, hearing loss, and even limb loss.
So it's good to know. It's good to know this. Make parents aware. Yeah, and this movie,
yeah,
this
topic,
this
and I think
film.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
Go ahead.
I think especially as our kids are going out into the world, you know, my daughter is going and she's traveling and she's looking at colleges, and you know, as they get to an age where they're really, you know, really going out into, you know, the world and going to be living in closer quarters, and of course, doing so many of the things that
they do, like share everything.
but it's important to have that conversation.
Good. I can tell that you both are very passionate about this. And how does someone watch the short film? Where can they watch?
Lifetime. Yay. And they can visit mylifetime.com/asktobesure.
Okay. We'll do
and also get more
now.
Get more information on asktobesure.com as well. So you can get that information about meningitis B vaccination. So you can have the conversation with people like me, your doctors, your healthcare providers. So just like we're having the conversation, we had the conversation, they can get that information and have those conversations.
Absolutely. And please watch the doc, because it's incredibly special to us.
Doctor, what was the most important question maybe Soleil asked you? And you were like, this is important.
Well, I think the first thing that she asked was about asking about meningitis B and meningitis B vaccination. It's important to know that there's two different meningitis vaccinations. One that's given at an earlier age, and that's against serotypes ACWY, and one meningitis B given at 16 to 23. And so just knowing about meningitis B, and that is a vaccination that's different than one, that a lot of people come to me and they think that they've already had it, and they haven't. They haven't had it. Meningitis B, and just learning about it, having that dialogue and having that conversation. So being aware of meningitis B and then starting that conversation.
Well, this is great. Yeah, you're both raising the awareness. Pretty good. Okay. And Soleil, if you could go back in time and tell Funky something now that you've learned all these years, what would you tell sweet, dear Funky?
Oh, that's such a great question. I would tell her that you still have your Punky power. And just how loved you are, mm-hmm. and that you are still so loved, and just to constantly hold on to that self-love, because it has grown and grown and grown. And thank you for inspiring me with the Punky power that has kept me strong all these years.
Oh, I love that. Well, everybody loves you, Soleil. You've been in our hearts all these years, and it's great that you're teaming up with Doctor to do this and to help people.
So
and Soleil, do you have a Tulane University connection? We have a producer that said you did.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, so here's the thing. So the father of my children did go to Tulane. I absolutely love New Orleans.
Yep.
I want to be.
Who doesn't? Yep.
Like that New Orleans.
New Orleans. You said it like a New Orleanian.
I love everything about it there. I love Cafe du Monde. No, I really love it so much there. And I love the music. I love the jazz. And I've really been encouraging my daughter to look at college there. Selfishly, it's like, you know, home to me in a way.
I hope she does come to Tulane, and then she'll be vaccinated against meningitis B and spread the word around campus. So this is awesome. Oh, good. Yeah, because I have friends. Yeah,
did I say friends. My baby's father or daddy? That was probably totally inappropriate. Okay.
I think it's funny. Well, it's funny because I have people that went to Tulane that said they were always seeing you around campus.
I did go to Mardi Gras. Yeah, okay. I would go visit.
I love it. Well, thank you, ladies. Bye.
Thank you.
Keep up the good work. Bye.
Thank you.
You. Bye.